Welcome everybody to Rapture Watch. It is the 17th of July 2019. Watchman on the Wall, William from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. And I hope all of you guys are having a blessed day in the Lord. And today I want to comfort those of you who may be coming to this video disappointed in what some people have been saying around the internet. I understand the disappointment. And but it's a feeling that you must go through to understand that only God the Father knows when we are going to go. And no man can know the hour, day or hour. And so, you know, we take comfort in that and we rejoice that our loved ones have another day. And that, quite frankly, we need to be a little bit more salty. And like always, I speak for myself as well. We got to get a little grittier and we have to have the heart of the Lord. You know, Jesus said, when he comes back, it'll be like the days of Noah and Lot. Now, I believe he was using both circumstances. One, to comfort us about our animals, because when Noah was spared, we also had the animals spared. And I truly believe that Jesus Christ is our ark. And we put our faith and trust in him. And also, I believe he used Lot as an example, because towards the end, when Lot had only, you know, it only would have taken a few people, 10, to save that area. So if you're the salt of your area, you're sparing wrath upon that area because of your purity and your salt. So I want to encourage you, believer, to stay where you are, to be the salt and light, and to do all you can to fight the evil in that area. Follow the Holy Spirit's leading and do what he says. The Lord, by his word, will lead all of us to exactly where we need to go. And I truly believe that all of us who are watching with a pure heart, who truly have the heart for the brethren, who understand date setting and date watching, and it's, you know, something that we are excited about, but we can't be selfish. And I say this a lot when date sets come and go, that you know, all of you guys, you know, there's two sets of you right now. There's some of you who are mad and there's some of you who are sad. So I'm going to address both. First, the mad, I want to address you as stop being selfish and see what the Lord went through and what he endured for your salvation. And he lives inside all of us and he suffers every second of every day with us. And so you have no right to be upset that he hasn't returned, because it's his goodwill and his good pleasure, and he will accomplish all of his word. Now, to you who are sad and in mourning, always go back to the Beatitudes. Blessed are those who are mourned, for they shall be comforted. And we must also hunger and thirst for righteousness. There's a lot of people out there who understand grace, but they quench the Spirit. When the Spirit is pulling them, they don't listen. And they suffer consequences. And I've dealt with this myself. And it's a short time, but once you are corrected, and each correction is different like every relationship, it's a custom relationship. And, you know, I truly believe the Lord waits till the very last moment to really, really have to, you know, some of you guys got a spanking as a kid. My mom, she didn't like doing it. She had to get drunk before she'd spank me. So she'd make me wait upstairs with my pants down by the bathtub and say, "I'll be up there and you just wait," and pretending to be all mean. And, you know, the wait, it was a surprise. You never knew when it was coming, but it was coming. And so I'm reminded of that, not as a someone who's going to get spanked by the Lord, but that the Lord is going to come suddenly out of nowhere, and the world is bent over waiting for the spank, and those who don't know. And the Lord is going to chasten those he loves and those who are his. And it's going to be a refiner's fire. So the easy way is to just follow what the Word and the Word says, and the Holy Spirit will comfort you. And that's it. That's all you got to do. You know, it sounds simple, but it's not. It's a daily grind, and we go through a lot of trials and tribulations to find our place in the kingdom. And when we realize our place and we realize our duties, and we're joyous about it, and you know, we want to serve the Lord because he gives us service that is what we want to do. You know, it's not, it's like these, I saw this video, I had to share it on my Facebook, about police dogs and how they have to do this balance training. And it looks like kind of mean, you know, what they're doing to the dogs, but these dogs need to train. And, you know, it's amazing what these dogs do. And, you know, the dog's blindfolded and he has to cross this, these two tight ropes and turn around and come back without touching the other side of the other side of the platform. So he has to balance himself on these ropes. And, you know, it got me thinking about how that's basically what we are. We are the canine unit of the Lord, and we're out to not punish, but we're out to scare off these unclean forces that we can't see. We're there to police our area, to watch out, and when we need to call the master to come and apprehend and take away whatever in need of prayer or whatever. We're prayer warriors. That's what I feel like. I mean, I think we all have different offices. We all have different jobs, but I believe that the Lord has made me part of his canine unit, you know, to help and pray and to find people. You know, that's what these dogs do. They don't just go and bite people or you know, are used to get shot at. They're officers, they're honored, they're named after fallen police officers mostly. And these dogs are to be honored, you know. And so that's what we should be. We should be not enforcers of the law, you know, but police dogs. We find the sin, and we help reveal it. We shed light, we pour salt on it, and we preserve what we can until the master comes and does his duty as he will. And we must have faith and not be feeling sorry for ourselves or negative about this stuff. Date sets are going to come and go, but trust the Word only, and you'll be comforted always. I love you guys. If I don't see you in the clouds tonight, I have another message for you very soon. Peace be with you.